Welcome back, guys. This is the one I've been looking forward to. We're going to upgrade to the double-decker trains, and I've got to say, I am so ridiculously excited to do this. I've got all the icons turned off at the moment, and we're running it on fast, because I'm hoping to get a bit more money in so that we can upgrade them. Fortunately, I've got a couple of things that I need to tell you about. It's the only thing, running it on 3x speed. You do get the occasional bit of lag. Right, let's have a look. Up here at the steelworks, I've now double tracked the iron mine, which I hadn't done before. And so now we've got these huge trains hauling the iron up here. Using these 1042s again. They are flying up and down here. And they are going to haul a lot of ore in here. There we go. Look at all the planks. So much cool stuff. So much cool stuff in this game. I've got to say, I am totally pumped. I am totally pumped by what's been going on. Like, the last few episodes have been, I mean, like, seriously, the last like 4 days, it has been like every hour of every day I've just been working on this to try and get all the stuff upgraded. I've now upgraded the Applejack lines, and there's some significant changes here that I need to tell you about. So obviously we've upgraded the actual Applejack line itself. 37 grain, it's just picked up. We'll take a look at the productivity in a bit. But do you remember that this used to haul the grain up here and then haul the food back? And then we had another station here. You can kind of see where it was. And then, so grain up, food back on the same train, and then the food over to Maceley, over to this station. Yeah, well, that's changed. Now, we've got the food line coming right up here. And we've got a couple of trains, again, 1042s, capable of hauling a lot of food. And they need to be, because there's a lot of food being produced. That's already hauling 121, and it's only got a capacity of 169. Mind you, the other train is actually kind of a bit bunched up with it. It's quite close to it at the moment. So this one's only got like 48. So hopefully they'll space out over time. And there's plenty of room. We could add a third train on here if we need to at some point. We're up to 1989. Let's just see what's the production here. Oh, coming up on 500. Sweet. Which probably means that there's... putting this tunnel in through... Let me show you. Where are we? Putting this extended line. Look at this huge tunnel under, and it's under quite a mountain here. This 10 million, just the track, and then I had to double track it, and the other one cost me another 8 million. These trains are costing like 20 million a piece. So I've got like, what did I spend? I spent a lot. Let's see, 97. New vehicles, 133 million. Wow. So let's see. I did that one, and I did the iron. Did I do anything else? I haven't done the Didcot one yet. I've still got to do that one. That's still got to get ramped up. But productivity in general, let's have a quick look. Productivity in general is really ramping up. Oh, all of these are starting to ramp up now. PG. Now, I was a little bit worried about the Honkelbrief oil refinery. Where is it? Honkelbrief oil refinery. This was way down, but it's jumped way up again now. So I'm not really sure what was going on. It just had a bit of a hiccup, I think. But everything's cool now. So that's churning out the fuel. If I turn the icons back on, you'll see that... Yeah. That's Sparksville. Where's Honkelbrief down here? Yeah. Loads of fuel being produced down here. And these trains are really... Look, full. And there's still fuel left for the next train. That's how good production is now. Is that turning into profits? Well, see for yourself. We did 120 million last year. And then, let's see, we spent 26 million on construction, 133, so that's what, 160 million. So, yeah, about 125 last year. So far, 70 million, 80 million, yeah. And it's really ticking up now. So, let's get this upgrade done, shall we? Oh, yes. You know what, let's turn trains on so that we can see trains. Okay, now I did wonder about doing the lines like one at a time, but I think we'll just whack them on. Oh, there's one thing I've got to show you. Oh, I've got to show you this before we upgrade, simply because it shows up. I think this is the best train to show it on. Look at this. A couple of people have sent me customized logos that I could put on my trains. Two people did it. It was Jeremy and Kim. Kim sent me this one. Look at this. He got the logos. This is from my channel art, this bit. And then the old Skystorm character. And there's different ones, and you'll see all kinds of different logos over the trains. By the way, I wanted to show you this as well. Look at the state of these trains. Look how grotty they are. Because how old is this train? Let's have a look. It's 26 years old. It's approaching the end of its life. And don't they look lovely and grotty? Don't they look awesome? God, this game has just got so much right. Visually, it's awesome. The gameplay is just so addictive and engrossing. It's just awesome. More Skystorm. And if you look on different trains, there's about 8 different logos in there. Something like that. Now that's that one, but I want to show you the others as well, because so that was the one that Kim got. And then let's see if I click on this, go down. Jeremy did me two versions. There's this one, which I've got to say, I really like this Skytrans. That is pretty sweet. And you see all the logos along the train. This is where it shows up best on this train. There's no question. And a filled-in one. This is basically the same, but it's filled in. Which, I gotta say, I think, out of the two, I like this one the best. I think that's great. I love the lightning bolt. But, because Kim... What I'm going to do is I'm... actually, Jeremy sent me another one, which I haven't had a chance to look at yet. So, I will have a look at that. But I've been kind of rushed. Because Kim sent it first... I'm going to use Kim's at the moment, and we'll switch between them. So there you go. Right, I had to show you that. Thank you both, Kim and Jeremy. You're awesome. Thank you for doing that. Very much appreciated. Let's have a look at the line profitability, and then we'll do the upgrade. So, because we want to look at the profitability before we change anything. So let's see. Halo 1 and 2 are currently making 56 and 54 million. I mean, that is really good. Halo Freight 2 and Halo Freight 1 are making 10 million apiece. Oh my lord. We're actually making a bit of profit. And a lot of these other lines are starting to make some pretty decent profits as well. Look at this, Confused with Oil, making almost 8 million. That's the revamped Applejack line. That's the food part coming into... That should be Maisley. Why can't I click on that? There we go. That should be Maisley, not Kimberly. Kimberly was the old name. Let's change that to Maisley so we know what the hell it is. That's Maisley. Oh, don't need the L-E-Y. Already got an L-E-Y. There we go. Yeah, so profits-wise, you know, like everything is going pretty freaking nicely. 140 million so far this year. Yeah, 143 million this year. So what did I say? I said I wanted to get up to like 150, 200. Well... Yeah, we're headed in the right direction. Right, we've got about 500 million now. Let's do it. Let's do the upgrade. So, let's just slow it down for a minute. Not Halo Freight. Where are they? Here we go. The Halo, line one. The Halo, line two. In fact, let's... I was going to pause it, but like, no, why pause it? I don't need to pause it. I do need to pause it for this. Because I don't want to accidentally screw this up. So, these are the double-decker trains. These are the double-decker cars. Now, what there is, there's a car, which is this thing, and it holds 33 passengers. Now, you compare that to the ones that we're using at the moment, and these hold 21, so it's a nice upgrade. And then, if we go down here, here's the TGVs. We will do some TGVs, definitely. Well, I want to get the speed, but it needs to be a really nice, long, straight track to get the speeds. And then this is the double-decker commuter train. There isn't a separate loco. The loco is built into a train. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this. Now, this thing has a capacity of 99. So we'll take one of those. And then we're going to add on a bunch of extra cars for it. So let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 extra cars. That gets us up to a capacity of, let's see, 150, about 260. About 260 on a train. So let's see. 25% replace, yes. Cool. That's that one. Then we want to do the same thing on this one. Set vehicle. Get rid of that so I don't screw up. And come down here. We want one of those. Now, these cost 13 million. And then each of these cars is almost 2 million a piece. So, what did I say? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, didn't I? Yeah. Yeah, 232 meters. Now, platforms are 240s. So, 25%. Yes. Oh, okay. So, these are costing 22 million each. And we are replacing how many? 14 on each line. That's 20. Call it 28. So 28. What's 28 times 22? It's about 500 million, which we've just about got. So we could just about afford to do this. Are we ready? Are we ready, guys? Let's have a look. Which one are we gonna watch upgrade? Let's see. Maybe the Nanny Giggles or the Princess Regina. Let's go and watch the Princess Regina. She'll be happy with me if I watch the Princess Regina upgrade. So, watch the Mallard. Enjoy the Mallard for the last time. Here it goes. Boom. Look at that. Now, these are very, very similar, if not the same, as the double-decker trains. Oh, pause for a second because I want to show you inside. I'm pretty sure these are the trains that I used to use in Switzerland, and they are absolutely freaking gorgeous. British trains suck. Like, they're horrible. They're just awful. But Swiss trains, especially these double-deckers, are just beautiful. And there's something about being like on an upper deck on a train, and you get to see more of the scenery and all the rest of it. And yeah, you go, you have a look inside. They are just sweet. And they're usually laid out. They've got tables and all kinds of stuff in there. They're really, really nice. Really luxurious, the trains in Switzerland. So, let's have a little bit of a ride, shall we? On the Princess Regina. You know what? I'm actually going to get rid of these for a bit. I'm sure everything's fine. I just want to enjoy this, because these trains are just so beautiful. Let's pop that right up in the corner. The doors close, and off we go. Oh, I love the noises they make. You see the driver? Yep, there he is. Now, I wonder whether he's Swiss German or whether he's French Swiss. Could be either, I don't know. You'd have to talk to him and guess from his accent. These models, I rave and rave, but I mean, come on. That is just insanely good. The only thing is, they haven't got my like big logo. It's like a little one down there. It's such a shame. I was hoping to see it like emblazoned on the side. I even like the colour scheme on these logos. Here we go. Now, what are we doing? We're doing 67. This is the steepest uphill section on the track. And he's actually picking up speed. 68. You gonna go any faster than that? Probably not. Now, if we were to switch, pause, if we were to switch to this one and check this out, I think this one, because it's going downhill, is going to pick up like a bit of speed. Let's have a look. That's a bit of a ride on the Mr. Mac. So once he gets out of the worst of the curve, here we go. Now he'll start to pick up some speed. Now these have got a top speed of 81. They're not especially fast trained, but that is kind of perfect for the kind of track that we're running on, where there isn't a huge gap between the cities, and the track lengths aren't that huge, and it's a bit curvy. So these trains pretty much make the best of the track that we've got. I'm just going to go back here because this needs a proper barrier in here. If I click on this, it'll give me a choice of two types of barrier. And this is, we want a proper half barrier crossing, don't we? Like that. There we go. The details in this game. Aren't they just freaking sweet? Now, this train is way overhanging this platform because this is one of the ones that I haven't upgraded. This is only a 160 meter. It needs to be upgraded to a 240. There are a few of the passenger stations which haven't been upgraded yet, so I'll have to do that. But things are going well. So let's have a look. How are we doing? Let's have a look. Yeah, they're all upgraded, and let's see, on Halo Line 2, oh, the last one just upgraded, Train 28. So, we've upgraded all the trains, and, oh my god, we've got 40 million left, woohoo, party. Oh, let's have more of a ride on the Mr. Mac. Let's just end this episode. This is why I've been looking forward to this episode so much, because this, I'm not going to do any building. I'm just going to enjoy it. We're going to be looking at the trains, looking at the scenery. Things are starting to get interesting now. Because there's a fair amount of stuff going on. The cities are starting to grow now. And we're going to be having a good old look around. And seeing like the stats on the towns and the population figures and stuff like that, and the productivity at the various places and the profits, and we're going to look at all of that kind of stuff. But primarily we're just going to freaking enjoy it. This is going to be a relaxing episode. I mean, I love the fact like these stations are starting to grow, especially where you run into the freight stations close to the passenger stations. It looks pretty epic. I mean, all the bridges along the rivers and stuff. Oh, I seriously, this is like the game of my dreams. It is so rare to find a game that strikes like all the right notes. It's beautiful to look at. incredible levels of realism, but it doesn't take it too far so that it spoils the gameplay. The gameplay is intricate, it's deep, but it's also fun. And you can go as far as you want, you know? Like, if you're a casual player, then you can play this on a casual basis, you know? You could just put in, you know, as much track as you want, link as many cities as you want. If you haven't got a powerful PC, you could play it on a smaller map. You don't have to play on one of these enormous, huge maps. And you'll find that even linking together three or four cities gives you a huge amount to do. Huge amount to do. I mean, I'm spending hours and hours on each city. Now, I'm giving this a bit of time, but I want to kind of keep an eye on the profitability on the lines. Halo 1 and 2 are currently running up. Now, remember, when they upgraded, they would have ditched all of their existing passengers. So it's going to take them a little while to get back up to full profits. But we were doing like 50, 55 million, so I'm hoping that these are going to be doing more. We've increased the capacity of the trains by about 25%, 25 to 30%. So if we were doing 50 million before, then we should be looking to do 65 million. So I would think 65, 70 million from each of these two lines, I would hope. And they're already jumping up there. They've already taken over top spot from the Halo freight lines. And it's nice to see the Halo freight lines up there. The other lines are making goodly amounts of money. And we're starting to see some of the GP lines up the top, which is sweet. And lots of them, nice and green, making hundreds of thousands. Look at all of these lines that are making money. Keep going down. Like, all these GP lines are making money now. And then we get down here, and a lot of the passenger lines that are struggling to make a bit of money. Now, we've got those bendy buses. We need to upgrade our buses. And of course, upgrading our buses will give us more passengers for the Halo lines. So, it's all good news. Yeah, there's one or two of the GPs in here. Well, there's a few of the GPs in here. And, oh, I'm surprised the Snogwarts Express isn't making money. Oh, I thought that'd definitely be making money. Yeah, it's a few of the passenger ones, a few of the... Now, for example, Premier 2K Fuel, I'm kind of surprised that that isn't making a profit. Let's have a look. Yeah. Let's go and have a look at that, shall we? See if we can. Yeah, let's go and have a look at a few lines and see if we can see what's up. Because I would have thought that should be making money, shouldn't it? Look. I wonder if. Let's have a look. Oh, it's an older train. It's not carrying that much, and I suppose it's on quite a hill. Maybe it's just struggling a little bit. Should we upgrade it? Oh, of course we should. Of course we should. Are you crazy? So what are we going to replace it with? Oh, well, now this is electrified already. So we can replace it with an electric train. Is it already upgraded to high speed tracks? No, it's not. So let's do a bit of high speed track upgrading. So we want to upgrade that. And that, and oh no, I just turn that off. That's better. Oh, it's because the line's red. It kind of makes it difficult to see. Yeah. Let's get rid of that for a minute. Come down. Thank you. Bye bye, Regina. So right now I can see to upgrade this line. Yeah, it's all high speed. It's all high speed. Now is this 240? No, it's a 160. Huh. But you know what? We can actually get away with it. I don't want to do any building, really. This is this should be a 240. This is you know what? If it's just that one station, we can extend it. So if we get rid of that and upgrade to 240. Oh, see, this is the thing. You say, well, I'll just do this one little bit. That might be enough. Let's see. Upgrade. Nope. Just here. Just that little bit there. Just take that up a touch there. And that should do it. Come on. Oh, seriously? Oh, I missed the spot. There. Oh, yeah, I guess down there. There we go. Now? No? Really? Oh, hang on a second. Now, there's a bit of track there. Ah, I missed a tiny little bit of track. There you go. Now I'll upgrade. There we go. Cha-ching. So that's in. All we've got to do is just hook that up. I'm not going to bother double tracking it. I'm just going to upgrade the train. So, because, like I said, this is going to be a relaxing one. Too much slope. Okay, we'll need to take it back a tiny bit more. Let's take it back a couple of sections. And then hopefully now just hook it up. Cha-ching. Awesome sauce. Right, so yeah, all I need to do is find the train, wherever it is. Here we go. And upgrade you. So get the line, replacement, 25%. No, choose the vehicle first. We're going to upgrade you to a 1042 and a bunch of oil trucks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 14. Oh. Yep, this is fuel. So, yeah, now, should I... Yeah, I suppose I've got to switch these to fuel. Good Lord. Seriously. It's a shame that there isn't, like, a clone button. So that you don't have to set them all individually. It's a very, very minor criticism that I have of the game. The big criticism of the game I have is the blooming upgrading. The upgrading, they seriously need to do something about that because it's just too painful. But this, it would be nice. It would be nice if you could just copy it to all the cars. Right, so 25%. That's the configuration we want. 239 meters. Yeah, 23.5 million. Let's do it. Go. Now, to all the people who've been commenting saying, oh, turn off the 25% auto-replace on the Halo freight lines. Yeah. It's like I've got 10 years to do that. And I do it after the episodes. So if we... Let's just watch this upgrade. Boom! There you go. Now that's a frickin' train. Oh, and it's got me on the front. Hooray! I'm on the front of the train! Oh, little things please me. Let's follow you while I'm showing you. So if we go to here and we go up here. How are we doing now? Oh, we're getting up to close to 20 million. Where's the Halo Line 1? Oh, it's down there. That's only doing 12 and a half. Grief. Mind you, I'm running it on slow, so which is fine. We'll run it on slow for a bit. End of year 1991. Do we want to see what profits we made last year? Be kind of nice, wouldn't it? Let's see. So we spent we spent 600 million. Okay, we spent 620 million and we only went down 408. So that means, guys, we made over 200 million last year. Wow. Okay, I'm slightly shocked. All right, so let's see, how much fuel are you going to get from here? 25 fuel on that enormous train. Hopefully, the production will ramp up a bit now. Be kind of nice. I wonder if it's limited by this one. Yeah, it's being limited by okay. Well, we've got to upgrade this. Did I double track it? Yep, it's double tracked. Have we got, how many trains have we got running? We've only got one train. Really? Okay, well, that needs to change. See, I said I wasn't going to do any. Well, I'm only upgrading. I'm not building, so. But I just need to check the line. Right, I double tracked it, but I never put any signals in because I was only running one train. Let's see, what size is the platform? It's, of course, it's a bloomin' 160. Oh, come on. Come on. Take that section out. That should let us upgrade. High speed 240. No, it's got to go back a little bit more. Yeah, that'll do. And catenary, yes. Apply. Cool. Okay. One thing I've learned, when you do it like this, like if you lay the first track in here, and then you lay a second track by the side and join it. Right, let me show you this, because I think this is a half decent tip. I think. You'll find when you try and join them up. Right, let's pull it back a little bit. When you join them up, you'll see. How far can we go? That's as far as we can go, I think. But you'll see that speed-wise, because these numbers here are showing you the maximum speed on that track. The maximum speed we're getting here is 66. Okay. Well, what I suggest is that you actually get rid of that part that's going the line that you did straight in. Then join this, right? And instead of 66, we're now getting 96, right? And then join this up to that one. Take it as far as you can. That'll do for me. And look at that, we're getting 157. So we've actually got the speed up on here by what, about 40 miles an hour? For those on the continent, that's about 60 kilometers per hour. It's just like multiply by 1.5 to get from miles an hour to kilometers per hour. So yeah, there you go. I think that's a half decent tip, because you get, see, it's, rather than one being quite curved, they both kind of blend together. Is that a good tip? Let me know if you thought that was a good tip. What am I doing? I want to upgrade these tracks, don't I? Yeah. So, like I said, it's be really nice if you could do this in one go. Upgrade to both. Okay, so let's. Oh, I just turned catenaries off. Idiot. On and on. That's on, good. What's the length of this platform? It's bound to be a blooming 160. Yeah, what a surprise. So I've got to do the same again at this end. So I'll do my same trick. So we'll take that one into the station. No, 94. Yeah, I can live with that. And then this one. Right, let's take it up to about like there. And then we'll blend it in. Yeah, 125, peachy. All right. What I should have done with this one while I was upgrading was... I forgot to... Oh, no, I did upgrade it. High speed. Oh, come on. Why can't I freaking upgrade? Well, you know what? It doesn't matter. The platform doesn't really need to be high speed. It would be nice, though, wouldn't it? God damn it. Run it back. Ugh, pain. And you. Oh, and there's a little bit of blooming track there. Let's get rid of that. There we go. Okay, so now I should be able to upgrade. Upgrade. 240 high speed catenary. Yes. Apply. Cha-ching. And lay you in. It's because I'm talking to you guys. That's what I'm going to blame it on. Let's see. That was the one that was straight, so I should have been doing that one, shouldn't I? Yeah, so let's take that one back. And let's see. Tracks, high speed contender, yes. So that's the one that we want to go into there. And then this one is the one that we want to blend in. And that's as far as it'll go, I think. All right, cool. So all I need to do is put some signals on this. So let's get the train up so I can see the line. We should be going up the right-hand side, which we are. So, signals. Put my one outside the track just to annoy certain people. Outside the station, rather. And then we want a signal about there. And signal about there. And one outside the station. If I can get it to go. Oh, yep. There we go. And I'll put a couple of in the middle. There and there. There we go. Cool. All right. So we should now be able to upgrade this. So what was I doing? Replacement. So that vehicle, we want a 1042. And we want a bunch of cars. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Cha-ching. Okay. And 25% replace. Yes. Now, where's the depot? The depot is here. That one's going up there. All right, now's a good time to actually buy the next train. So we want to buy another one, which would be exactly the same spec. So one of those. And oil cars. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Nope, one more. There we go. And set you online. What is this? This is the Premier 2K crude oil. Boom. Done. Go. Let's get rid of all of this stuff. Oh, and here comes our new rolling stock sliding out of the depot. Sweet. Right, let's crank it up, see if it works. So, you are going to go up here and upgrade. Sweet. How much oil have we got? Answer, not very much at the moment, but hopefully that is now going to start to really increase. 370, it's not too bad. What's this doing? This is 250. So hopefully we'll really ramp those up. Okay, we're back running on fast. What do we want to look at? We want to look at productivity in general, don't we? Now, I think this is the next one that needs to be upgraded, but I don't know whether we're going to do that now. I don't know. We might. If there's no other issues, we might do that one as well. Because that's like the last one. All the others are doing. We're up to the 40 millions now. With the Halo lines. And Halo Freight 1 is doing 14 million. Halo Freight 2 is doing almost 10 million. Wow. Awesome. Rogi Oil is picking up now. That's up to 3 million. My God. Lieselot is doing like a couple of million. That's still the hovercraft, isn't it? Oh, do you want to listen to the annoying hovercraft noises? Because I know so many of you loved those hovercraft noises. Let's go in really close so that it's really loud. This is making some damn good money. People obviously like riding on the hovercraft. Quick, hurry up. Come on, hurry up, you'll miss it. Ah, too late, losers. Nah. There we go. Shall I back off? Because it's very noisy, isn't it? Yeah, it is very noisy. I'm amazed that that's making so much money. That's sweet. Alrighty. Now, I tell you one thing that I wanted to actually show you. Right, you can see how many tall buildings there are around here. Come over here and look at Bickerty. Look at Bickerty's Hollow. My God, look at this. Look at this one. This place is like turning into Los Angeles. But what we need to do with this, this is another one that hasn't been upgraded. This is a 160. Yeah, this is a 160. What we need to do here is we need to upgrade this and get the a road coming out on the other side as well, the second road entrance. And then we need to develop the city on this side of the tracks as well, so that we end up with like a huge city expanding out here. That would be so sweet. I can't wait to do that. Oh my Lord. Look at all this stuff that's going on. Look at this. Lots of oil. And you can take all of it. And then there's loads of oil for the fuel for these to ship. Now, you know what? We don't have enough trucks on here. What line is this? This is the Confucedford fuel. Because when I put this in, I thought, I'll just put a few trucks in for now. But yeah, we need more trucks than that. Let's get a few more trucks going. We've got the 40-ton trucks now. Oh, hell yeah. What's the capacity on these? These are, the mans are 16 capacity. These are, oh, they're only 20? Really? But they'll do 62 miles an hour. And the loading speed is times 5 as opposed to times 4. So we definitely want to upgrade. Should we, how old are these? Let's have a look. These are 19 years old. Yeah, we can insta upgrade these. Cool. So replace, set vehicle, 40 ton truck. Okay, 25%, yes. Now, do I want to specify that they only haul fuel? Yes, I do. Only haul fuel. That's quite important here because this is the oil well right here. Is it the oil well? Or is that, I can't remember now. This is the oil well, so we definitely don't want the oil accidentally ended up over here. So what was I doing? Yes. Okay, that's fine. But we want some, yeah, we want some more trucks. What did I say? There were 6? Yeah. Let's get 1, 2, 3, 4. At least another 4, I would have thought. Yeah. Set that. This is RF Confused Third Fuel. Boom. All right. Oh, man. Let's go. Oh, there's the first one. Let's go and have a look. Let's go and take a little look at you. Okay, these are proper trucks. What we call in the UK... Well, actually, I suppose we still do. Not as much as... I think the term's kind of gone out of fashion a little bit, but we used to call them Artics. Short for Articulated Lorry. Ah, look at that big Artic over there. I'm trying to think what we call them now. Lorries, I suppose. Wow, they're quite cool. They're quite cool. Oh, picking up all the fuel. Okay, so that is going to improve this whole line. And we're already getting plenty of construction materials to be hauled. But now we're going to have, hopefully, tons of fuel here as well to be hauled, which is going to improve the profitability of the Halo Freight 2. And then over at Maceley, how are we doing with the food? There's loads of food here. freaking tons of it. Which is awesome, because it means that these guys will be running around fully loaded with fuel, with food. Peachy! Oh, and we get the Airbus A320. Right, I think we've just gone through year end, so let's have a look. Let's have a look. How are we doing profits-wise? Oh, last year, 149 million. And how are we doing on the Halo lines? Oh my God, 75 million apiece. Halo Freight 2 is doing 12. Halo Freight 1 is doing almost 10. So, yeah. I am reasonably pleased. And of course, some of the improvements that we've made are going to take a little bit of time to feed through. So, yeah, I said I wanted to get to between 150 and 200. And I think we've done it.
Let's have a quick look at the factory production and see where we would need to...
Oh, look at this. Dartford Quarry is now approaching 1,000. Hastings getting up for 900. Plenty at 700, 600, 500. Wow. So the one that's not doing particularly well at the moment is the steel mill. Now, have I screwed something up when I did the ore mine? It's possible. Just go and have a look. Let's go and have a look at the steel mill, because that should be producing a lot more now, and it's not. So I've probably screwed something up with the iron ore. Let's have a look. So there's the iron ore. That curve is very slow. I should probably redo that. Yeah, that's pretty nasty. I mean, we're running on slow, but even so, that could be so much nicer. And then the trains would be a lot faster. But even so, let's have a look at you. So, yeah, you're doing okay speed-wise. Here comes this guy. So the trains are working. So in that case, why the hell are you not... Look at this. He's producing next to nothing. Now, why? Why? What's up with you? Gull Steel Mill. You've got potential, but you're not doing anything. Why not? We've got line usage, yes. Production is just locked at this, like, 200 level, and it just won't do any more. It's got the potential to take more. Let's have a look. How much so? It's got 191. It's got 190 iron stored. It's got 200 coal stored. So why isn't the production like a lot higher? So I don't know. I don't know. What's holding this up? It's not the coal. It's not the ore. You know what? If you can tell me what's wrong with that, please do, because I don't understand why that isn't producing a lot more than it's producing right now. It doesn't make any sense. Anyway, screw that. I'm going to go back to enjoying all the stuff that is working. So let's have a look at the factory production again. So we've got the coal mine, the steel mill, and the iron ore is low, and the machine factory. So that's all part of the same production chain. And then the next one is the Ghoul oil well. The Didcot food we haven't upgraded yet. I said we were going to do that. I'll probably do that offline because it'll be fine. But this Ghoul oil well, why is that not producing more? Yeah, why aren't you producing more? Were you just having a little lull? He's on his way back up. 390. Yeah, he's on his way back up. All right. Let's get back to running at high speed. So, where do we go from here then, guys? Oh, look at this. How much oil are you carrying now? 71, so he can still carry a lot more.
We've got loads of fuel sitting here, so you must have a full load of fuel. Yes, he has. Cool. Oh, end of year. Cool, let's have a look. How much did we make last year? So, let's see, we spent... new vehicles... Yeah, only 4 mil. So, oh my god! Oh my god! We made 220 million last year. Okay, well, we beat my target of 150 to 200 million. Yeah. To say that I'm pleased is a minor understatement, and I think it demonstrates that I've got a basic handle on the mechanics of the game now, although there are certain instances where it still puzzles me about what exactly is going on. I think we will leave it there, guys. Should we have a quick look at the profitability of the lines? 70 million, 77, 70. Yeah, I said about 65, 70, didn't I? Cool. So that's up in the around 70 million each. Halo Freight 2 is now making 22 million. I'd like to see Halo Freight 1 making more. I don't know why that's not making more. Although it would be making more if our freaking tools factory would start actually producing. Come on, you piece of garbage, make more. I don't know what's wrong with this. I really don't. I hope some one of you comes up with the answer and goes, Scott, you're an idiot. It's because of this. Some simple fix. Alrighty, I'm going to cheer myself up by looking at the production, because the production levels are really good. I'm really pleased that these are getting up into the 700-800s. But I want to go higher. I want to start having factories and whatever in the thousands. So what I'm going to be looking for now is like second sources of supply. So for example, we've got this producing stone for this. But I don't know. Can we find another one? Or maybe, okay, we've got another factory here, right? What would happen if you hook this up to this factory as well? Will it go, oh, right, well, I've got increased production capacity, so I'll start producing even more. And do you actually get, like, is it greater than the sum of the parts, or? I don't know. But that's kind of, if we're going to take it to the next level, that's what we need to investigate. How we get our production up from the level that we're up to, now, into, like, the 1,000-plus level. And start really churning it out. I need to put in more point-to-point stuff, because we're getting a lot of this stuff building up on the Halo Freight Line. Because the Halo Freight Lines just are not cutting it. So we need to ship these more directly into places like Confusedford. I just want to have a quick look at this. My God, I think we need more trucks on this line. Look at all this. Oh man, we didn't do the one thing that I said we were going to do, which was to actually look at the cities and see. Look at this. We're only providing like 17%. Wow. I'm really surprised about that. Okay, well, I think we need to. I think we need to do a big upgrade, and I've definitely got some lag going on now. Ouch! When you run it on three times with the amount of stuff that I've got in now, yeah, it's kind of not too much of a surprise. Yeah, I need to look at these lines, and the thing is, I've just upgraded these lines, so like that line should be working like really, really well, and I'm kind of surprised that it's not. I'm tempted to actually have a look and see why it's not. Let's have a look. Vehicles. We've got a lot, like, there's loads of man trucks on there, right? They should be going, like, it was going fantastically well. What the hell's happened? I mean, look at this, making 2 million a year, this line, hauling that stuff in there. I don't know. I wonder if there's a traffic snarl up or something. I'm going to have a look. Because unless we're just putting so much on here that these guys can't cope. But I kind of don't really believe that. All it's doing is hauling direct to here, to the Confusedford branch. So, I don't know. I'm going to look at that offline, guys. This episode is already extremely long, I think, so we'll leave it there. I hope that you are enjoying this. I am freaking loving it. I love these double-decker trains. I suppose we should leave on a double-decker train, shouldn't we? We should. Let's have a look at train 23. And we'll have a little look at the double-decker train cruising along by the river. That's not a bad sight, is it? Come on, that is not a bad sight. All right, guys, we'll leave it there. Leave me your comments. I'll catch you for the next one. Peace out.